Hey everyone, Greg Meskel here for Lakers Nation. When you think of the all-time best left-handed guards for the LA Lakers, Derek Fisher has to come to mind. But long before Fish ever suited up for LA, a high-scoring 6'1" guard out of UCLA named Gail Goodrich helped the Lakers to an NBA championship. A territorial draft pick of the Lakers in 1965, Goodrich had two very different stints with LA. His first 3 years, he was largely a bench player before being taken by the Phoenix Suns in the expansion draft. When he returned to LA in 1970, things had changed, and Goodrich was one of the league's top guards. Now we take a look at Gail Goodrich's top five moments with the Lakers. At number five, we start with Goodrich's first go-around with the Lakers from 1965 to 1968. Initially thought to be undersized, Goodrich didn't get as much playing time in those days, but in his rookie season in 1965, he went off for a career-high 25 points in a win over the San Francisco Warriors on December 23rd. That season, the Lakers advanced to the NBA Finals before falling to Boston. The big game by Goodrich was a preview of what was to come later in his career. To number four, and a move Goodrich made off the court that led to a whole host of Lakers success. When his time with the Lakers ended in 1976, Goodrich decided to sign a contract with the New Orleans Jazz, paying him more than $1 million, a ton of money at the time. League rules stated the Lakers would be awarded draft picks as compensation for losing a valuable free agent. You might know where this is going. With the Jazz finishing with the worst record in the 1978-79 season, they held the top pick the following year, only it belonged to the Lakers, who used it on Magic Johnson. The rest, as they say, is history. For number three, we move to the 1974-75 season, Goodrich's second to last with the Lakers. Goodrich made news when, at age 31, he dropped 10 pounds to get in better shape. It helped as he led the Lakers in scoring at 22.6 points per game. The high water mark of that season for Goodrich's offensive exploits came on March 28, 1975, when Goodrich scorched the Kansas City Kings for a career-high 53 points. It was the first time Goodrich scored over 50 points in a game. Let's move to number two and back a year to the 73-74 season, arguably the best in Goodrich's career from a numbers standpoint. Playing alongside Jerry West in his final NBA season, Goodrich would average 25.3 points per game, score over 2,000 points in the season, and again be named an NBA All-Star and first-team All-NBA. On October 28, 1973, Goodrich lit up the Portland Trail Blazers for 49 points, a then-career high. At number one, we go to the 1971-72 season. Goodrich played in every game that year, helping the Lakers to a record 33-game win streak during the regular season. Goodrich scored 30 points or more in a game 28 times and pushed the Lakers to the NBA Finals, where they would meet the New York Knicks. After a Game 1 loss to New York, Goodrich came back with 31 points in Game 2 to help the Lakers to victory. With dominant play from Goodrich, Wilt Chamberlain, and Jerry West, LA won the next three games to take the crown. Goodrich was officially a star as he averaged a series-leading 25.6 points per game in the NBA Finals. So there you have it, five of the best moments from Gail Goodrich. Next time you're at the Staples Center and you see number 25 in the rafters, you'll know why. Same goes for Pauley Pavilion, where Goodrich has his number 25 retired by the UCLA Bruins. We should also mention in 1996, Goodrich was inducted into the NBA Hall of Fame. Not bad for a guy that, because of his height, Elgin Baylor nicknamed Stumpy. What did you think about Gail Goodrich? Did you know he was this good? Let us know down in the comments section or tweet at us at Lakers Nation. Thanks for watching.